تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in his noble book, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Do you all see that it prostrates to Allah all that is in the heavens and the earth? Don't you all see that all that is in the heavens and the earth prostrates to Allah, and the sun, وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرُ, and the sun and the moon, وَالنُّجُومُ وَالْجِبَالُ, and the stars and the mountains, وَالشَّجَرَ وَالدَّوَابَ, and the trees and the animals, وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ, and many of the people, وَكَثِيرٌ حَقَ عَلَيْهِ الْعَذَابِ, and many of the people, they are deserving of punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَفْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ, and most of the people, and if you were eager and worked hard in guiding them, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad, they will not be believers. Most of the people. The first ayat that we read, it shows that most of the people, they deserve the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in this verse, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَفْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ, and most of the people will not be believers. If you are anxious and working hard and being diligent and trying to guide him to Islam, and this speech is directed to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. والله سبحانه وتعالى he says, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Certainly in that is a sign, and most of them are not believers. Most of them were not believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeats this ayat throughout Surah Ash-Shu'ara, after he mentions the story of the people of the Prophet Nuh. He says, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ آيَةٌ, and in that story is an ayat, وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ, and most of them weren't believers. And after he mentions the story of the Prophet Lut and the story of the Prophet Saleh wa Shu'aib and the Prophet Hud, after each story the Prophet says, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ, and certainly in that is a sign, وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ, and most of them they were not believers. We want to benefit today to look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned about mankind, and most of them will not believe, and that most of them are disobedient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّوكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, says to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and if you were to obey most of the people in the land, in the earth, in the world, they will lead you astray from the path of Allah. If you will follow the most of the people, they will lead you astray. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says concerning the believers, وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ لَاتَّبَعْتُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ illa qalila. If it wasn't for the virtues of Allah upon you and His mercy, you all would have followed a shaytan, except a little bit of you. Most of the people fall into disobedience, are disobedient, except a few. Only a small number are rightly guided and steadfast upon obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this clear in his book as he explains us about all of the prophets and the messengers, that their followers were few. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about his prophet Nuh, وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ, and nobody believed him and followed him except a little bit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Musa, فَمَا آمَنَ لِمُوسَى فَمَا آمَنَ لِمُوسَى إِلَّا ذُرِّيَّةٌ عَلَى خَوْفٌ مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ إِلَّا ذُرِّيَّةٌ مِنْ قَوْمِهِ. Allah says that nobody believed in Musa except the offsprings from his people. In the second generation, the youth, nobody believed in Musa illa dhurriyatun, except the offsprings. And it comes in the hadith of Ibn Abbas, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, uridat alayya al-umam, that all of the nations have been presented before me. فَرَأَيْتُ النَّبِيِّ وَمَعَهُ رُهَيْطٌ, all of the nations that have proceeded before me were presented before me. They were presented. So I saw a prophet, he had a small group with him. وَرَأَيْتُ النَّبِيِّ وَمَعَهُ الرَّجُلُ وَالرَّجُلَانِ, and I saw a prophet, he had one man or two men with him. وَرَأَيْتُ النَّبِيِّ وَلَيْسَ مَعَهُ أَحَدٌ, and I saw a prophet, he had nobody with him. A prophet. His followers are Ruhayt. Ruhayt is up to 9-10 people. That's how many followers he has. And he's a prophet. He's upon the truth. This is an Asura prophet, to understand with certainty that the criterion is not numbers, and that our goal and our objective is not to bring in the numbers, but we are the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to obey him. This is our objective, and we want to be with the truth, even if it's with a little bit. It is upon us to obey Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to obey him, and this is what he has made wajib upon us. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. It comes in the hadith of Zainab bint Jahshin. At the end of the hadith, well, the hadith was in Sahih, Sahih Muslim. Qultu ya Rasulullah, anahliku wa fina salihun, are we going to be destroyed and there's amongst us righteous people? Qala na'am, idha kathur al-khabath. Yes. He said, yes, we will be destroyed if the sins and the khabath and the disobedience is abundant. Anahliku wa fina salihun. Are we going to be destroyed and there's amongst us righteous people? Qala na'am. He said, yes. Idha kathur al-khabath. Yes. He said, yes. If the khabath, meaning the sins and the disobedience, is abundant. With this in mind, we want to know that Ahlul Sunnah, that the people of the Sunnah, they call to the obedience of Allah and to ilm and understanding the deen and practicing this deen. And their concern It's not bringing in the numbers. And those who make their objective and their goal to bring in the numbers, you find that they fall into sin and they look over sins. They overlook sins. They fall into sins. And ignorance is something that becomes prevalent with them. A lack of seeking ilm. And this is the way of the deviant and those who are not upon the sunnah. They try to bring in numbers. So their major concern is numbers. No matter how it comes, just be down. Put your money down. As long as you put your money down, we accept that. You're accepted with us. So we want to take a look at situations in the book of Allah and the sunnah of His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at the prophets and the righteous from before us, that they in the time when they're in need of numbers, at a time when they're in need of large numbers, they put their trust in Allah. And they sought the righteous and freed themselves from the unrighteous. Because the barakah is from Allah. إِذَا كَثُرَ الْخَبَثِ, if the disobedience is in abundance, then this is destruction, as it comes in the hadith you previously read. It comes in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah mentions in Surah Al-Baqarah. In the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, starts from the ayat number 246. أنه سبحانه وتعالى قال ألم تر إلى الملأ من بني إسرائيل من بعد موسى إذ قالوا لنبي لهم ابعث لنا ملكا نقاتل في سبيل الله. Don't you see the group from Bani Israel, from the children of Israel, that they came after Musa, when they said to a prophet from amongst them, appoint for us a king so that we can fight in the name of Allah. Appoint for us a king, a ruler, somebody to guide us that we can follow him and fight in the name of Allah. So their prophet said to them, قال هل عصيتم إن كتب عليكم القتال ألا تقاتلوا. He said, would you all refrain from fighting if it was written and prescribed for you all? Would you all refrain? قَالُوا وَمَا لَنَا أَنْ لَا نُقَاتِلَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. What would be wrong with us? Why wouldn't we fight in the name of Allah? وَقَدْ أُخْرِجَنَا مِنْ دِيَارِنَا وَأَبْنَائِنَا. And we've been driven away from our homes. We've been driven away from our children. فَلَمَّا كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقِتَالِ, when the fighting was prescribed for them, تَوَلَّوْا إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِّنْهُمْ, they fled except a little bit from amongst them. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ, and Allah is aware of the wrongdoers. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this story, and that He appointed for them a king whose name was Talut. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, throughout the story, He says, فَلَمَّا فَصَلَ طَالُوتُ بِالْجُنُودِ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ. When Talut moved out with the army, he prepared his army, and he was ready to move out with his army, he says to them, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مُبْتَلِيكُمْ بِنَهَرٍ, Allah is going to test you all, Allah is testing you all, and trying you all with a river. فَمَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي, whoever drinks from this river, then he is not from me, meaning I'm free from him. You all cannot drink from this river. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَطْعَمْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي, and whoever doesn't drink from it, then he's from me, he's with me. إِلَّا مَنِ اغْتَرَفَ غُرْفَةً بِيَدِهِ, except those that take one drink with their hand, just one little drink, this is accepted, this is permissible. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested these people. At the time when it's time for them to fight, they're going to want to get enough preparation from themselves and drink. Allah prohibited from them to drink. And these people were tested to see which of them would be patient and which of them would be obedient and which of them would be disobedient. From amongst them are those that disobeyed, and they drank a lot. From amongst those who were first and foremost, they didn't drink any. It was a patient, the first and foremost. And from amongst them, all those who took that which was allowed for them to take, and they drank a little bit. قال الله تعالى فشربوا منه إلا قليلا منه. Allah said, and they drank from it except a little bit from them. They all drank from it after they were prohibited from it. It's only the small group that is obedient. Most of the people were being disobedient. فَلَمَّا جَاوَزَهُ هُوَ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ قَالُوا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا الْيَوْمَ بِجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ. When they passed the river, now the ones that are with him now are the ones that didn't drink, and the ones that just drank a little bit. The ones that drank a lot, they left him. فَلَمَّا جَاوَزُهُ, when he and his army, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ, and those the believers that are with him, everybody that's with him is believers. But they're on two categories. Those that did not drink anything, the foremost and the patient, and those that were a little weaker, and they did what that was permissible for them to do, and they drank some. قَالُوا لَا طَاقَةَ لَنَا الْيَوْمِ بِجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ. The ones that drank a little bit, they said, it's no way, we don't have the strength, and we don't have the power in order to fight Jalut and his army. قَالَ الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُ اللَّهِ. So the other ones that didn't drink anything, the ones that they were certain that they were going to meet Allah, they said to their brothers as a form of advising them and reminding them, كَمْ مِنْ فِئَةٍ قَلِيلَةٍ غَلَبَتْ فِئَةً كَثِيرَةً بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. How many of a small group of people dominated and conquered a large number of a large group of people with Allah's permission? وَاللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ, and Allah is with the patient. How many small groups of people conquered a large number of people with Allah's permission? الْبَرَكَةُ مِنْ اللَّهِ. Barakah is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Large numbers, they don't benefit. This prophet here, he didn't want large numbers. He wanted a group that was salih, righteous group. أَنَهْلِكُ وَفِينَ الصَّالِحُونَ. Are we going to be destroyed and there's righteous from amongst us? نَعَمْ إِذَا كَثُرَ الْخَبَثُ. Yes, we will be destroyed if the khabath is in abundance, if the sins and the disobedience is in abundance. This is destruction. There's no benefit to bring it in the numbers, except that if it's in obedience to Allah. Other than that, there's no benefit. This is the way of the prophets and the righteous before us. As it comes in Sahihain, in Hadith Abi Huraira, قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم غزا نبي من الأنبياء صلوات الله وسلامه عليهم. A prophet from amongst the prophets went out on an expedition, meaning to fight. May the peace and the blessings of Allah be upon all of them. فقال لقومه, So he said to his people, لا يتبعني رجل ملك بضع امرأة وهو يريد أن يبني بها ولم يبني بها. Do not follow me and my army, any man that married a woman and he has yet to consummate the marriage, he has yet to have relations with his wife and he wants to have relations with her. Nobody follow me from amongst this kind. He got married, but he has yet to have relations with his wife. Nobody follow me from this kind. وَلَا أَحَدٌ بَنَى بُيُوتٌ لَمْ يَرْفَعْ سُقُوفَهَا. And nobody follow me who has built a house, but he didn't put the roof on the house yet. Nobody of this kind, nobody follow me in my army. I don't want anybody like that with me. وَلَا أَحَدٌ اشْتَرَى غَنَمًا أَوْ خَلِيفَاتٍ وَهُوَ يَنْتَبِرُ أَوْلَادَهَا. And nobody follow me who have bought a bunch of goats and camels and they were pregnant and he's waiting for these animals to give birth to see how many goats and camels he's going to have. He doesn't want this kind of people with him. Somebody's going to have his mind on his woman, on his dunya. Now I'm on his house, on his animals, distracted. At a time when he is in need of numbers, he's going to fight. And these people are not disobedient people. They're not disobedient. What's the sin in marrying a woman and you haven't had relations with her? What's the sin in building a house and you have yet to put the roof on it? Or what's the sin of buying some goats and camels and you're waiting for them to give birth? But this is not the qualified group that's for fighting. So he didn't want anybody of this kind to follow him. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى قل لا يستوي الخبيث والطيب ولو أعجبك كثرة الخبيث فاتقوا الله يا أولي الألباب لعلكم تفلحون. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says to the Prophet, say, it is not the same الخبيث والطيب. The خبيث and the طيب is not the same. That which is khabith and that which is not wholesome and not good and sinful and dirty, it's not the same with that which is tayyib and that which is good and wholesome. قُلْ لَا يَسْتَوِي الْخَبِيثُ وَالطَّيِّبُ. It is not the same, the khabith and the tayyib. وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثُ. Even if you're pleased with a lot of khabith, it's still not the same. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. So fear Allah, O you people of intelligence and intellect, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you will be successful. The matter of being successful is this, knowing that the issue of having a lot is not the objective and is not the goal. قُلْ لَا يَسْتَوِي الْخَبِيثُ وَالطَّيِّبُ. الخبيث والطيب is not the same. وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكَ كَثْرَةُ الْخَبِيثِ. Even if you're pleased with a lot of the khabith, even if this is pleasing to you, even if you have a lot of it, it's still not the same. But tayyib is what needs to be sought after. The tayyib is that which is good. So Allah says after this, fattaqullah, therefore fear Allah. Ya ulil albab, O you who have intellect, la'allakum tuflihun, so that you may be successful. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, he used to take an allegiance from his companions, but this allegiance that he took from them was with the condition of obedience to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the surah of Mumtahina about the women who give the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam al-bay'ah, yani allegiance. Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu, O Prophet, idha ja'aka min al-mu'minati yubay'anaka If women come to you, if believing women come to you to give you allegiance, then it's the condition that they have to give their allegiance to the Prophet. Allah yushrikna billahi shay'a, that they don't associate any partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَسْرِقْنَا, and that they don't steal. وَلَا يَزْنِينَ, what they don't fornicate. وَلَا يَقْتُلْنَ أَوْلَادُهُنَّ, and that they don't kill their children. وَلَا يَأْتِينَ بِبُهْتَانٍ, and they don't come with lies. يَفْتَرِينَهُ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِنَّ وَأَرُجُلِهِنَّ, that they don't come with lies, spreading it amongst themselves. وَلَا يَعْصِينَكَ فِي مَعْرُوفٍ, and that they don't disobey you in that which is correct. If they do that, if they give you an allegiance and they're willing to give you an allegiance with these conditions, fada yehunna, then give them the allegiance. Wastaghfir lahunna Allah, and ask Allah to forgive them. Inna Allah ghafur rahim, Allah is forgiving and merciful. Wa fi sahihain an Jarir ibn Abdullah al-Bajali, it comes in Bukhari and Muslim, on the authority of Jarir ibn Abdullah al-Bajali, قال بايعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على إقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة والنصح لكل مسلم. So that gave the Prophet the allegiance upon establishing the Salah and paying the Zakah and giving advice or being sincere to every Muslim. It's not just get down. You with us? MashaAllah. You put your money down, you with us. The issue is far, far greater than that. The issue is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the issue that we're talking about is a lack of obedience to Allah. We're not even looking at the issue that maybe some brothers may not memorize, as very few people have memorized the Quran. Aware of those that memorize the Riyadh al-Salihin. No. Just obedience to Allah. We're the ones that's not going to look at the haram. We're the ones that are not going to look at TV and go to the movies. Na'am. And look at DVD videos. And look at the haram. We're the ones that are going to stay away from ikhtilaf. Things that we know is haram. So the issue that Ahlul Sunnah calls to is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If it's not going to be with obedience, we don't want it. The mahabara, the lecture, the conference has to be upon obedience to Allah. The object is not to bring in the numbers. The object is ilm. It doesn't need that fancy, glittering flyer or website. You say Fulan is going to be there, and he's from such and such, and he studied here, and he's with this, and who's with that, and who's that? Who's with the haq? Allahumma as-sabirin. Allah is with the patient. Inna Allah ma'a alladhina attaqaw walladhina hum muhsinun. Allah is with those who have taqwa and those who do good. Not the issue that Fulan is with me and I'm with Fulan. Who are they with? Well, the Sheikh is with them. Allahumma alladhina taqaw. Allah is with the people who have taqwa. Who's going to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the deen that the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam or his companions were upon? It's not about who's going to be with you and who you with and the Sheikh is with you. La, the issue is greater than that. We've been called to the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى ولو أنا كتبنا عليهم, and if we had written upon them أن يقتلوا, I mean prescribed for them and commanded them أن يقتلوا أنفسكم, to kill yourselves أو يخرجوا من دياركم, or to leave your houses, ما فعلوه إلا قليل منهم, none of them would have done it except a little bit from amongst them. ولو أنهم فعلوا ما يوعظون به, and if they had only done that which they had been advised with and admonished with, لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ,
it would have been better for them. وَأَشَدَّ تَثْبِيتًا. It would have made them more firm on the deen. وَإِذًا لَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ لَدُنَّ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. وَإِذًا لَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ لَدُنَّ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. And we have given them. If they had done that, we have given them from ourselves a large reward, a great reward. وَلَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ صِرَاطٌ مُسْتَقِيمًا. And we will have guided them to the straight path. Obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The issue is obedience to Allah. So the issue is establishing da'wah, establishing a masjid, establishing a community. It's not an issue of numbers, not an issue of money. A da'wah as-salafiyah is a da'wah of ilm. Look at the salaf before us, and look at the hal of the Prophet. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam.
The credit on your card is low.
The Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam,
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Sorry for the interruption. The brother wasn't through yet, but inshallah we will get him back. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Naam, tafadhal.
Naam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, he was in Mecca for 13 years. And he was permitted and commanded to make hijrah after being in Mecca for 13 years. And when he went to Medina, he established the first masjid. 13 years, no masjid. Walakin da'wah azimah. He had da'wah with no masjid. More than half of the Quran, nearly 80 surahs from the Quran, was revealed in Mecca. The issue is obedience to Allah. This is not a masjid. The issue of establishing a community is not that you go look for an old building to renovate. The issue is obedience to Allah. Calling the people and educating the people that they may obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not to make excuses. And to say our condition calls for us to do such and such. Meaning our condition calls for us to follow other than that which the Prophet and his companions were upon. Oh, stop making excuses. We have to be upon the tariq of the Salaf with no excuses. That's why we're not in a Muslim country and we don't have the funds that they have. Your situation is tied in the situation of the Prophet and his companions, the ones who used to tie rocks on his stomach, alayhi salatu wasalam, who him and his family, 3 months, they ate aswadan, the two black things, water and dates. Our situation is not like that. You have masajid. We have masajid. We have to be upon obedience to Allah. We have no excuse. We have to be upon obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, we want to understand that these situations call for patience. The situations of establishing the community, it calls for patience from those that are leading the community
and those that are in charge of the community and those that are making ta'awun with the community. And you all, my dear listeners, you are the community. You all are the community. If there's from amongst you that is able to teach brothers how to read Arabic, then you should take it amongst yourselves to try to get that done and teach. And if you see that something needs to be advised about, you should take the necessary measures and see and advise in a wise manner, in a manner that is suitable. You all are the community. And it's very important for us to understand that these situations, they call for patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He calls to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be patient. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He wanted to, He could help His Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam immediately. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rather wants him to be patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in His book, وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Be patient. And what is your patience except that is from Allah? The patience that you have is going to come from Allah. So put your trust in Allah and be patient. Establishing a community, it takes patience. It's not for us that when the doors open, and we think we got to get the numbers in. We got to find a way to get the money. Just try to sell some fish sandwiches. The issue is obedience to Allah. The issue is obedience to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Wasbir, wa ma saburuka illa billah." Be patient. And what is your patience except that is from Allah? وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ. And don't be depressed over them. وَلَا تَكُوا فِي ضَيْقٍ مِمَّا يَمْكُرُونَ. And don't be في ضيق and in anxiety because of the things that they plot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commands His Prophet here to be patient. And not to be depressed over them. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكَ بَاخِئٌ نَفْسَكَ أَن لَا يَكُونُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ. Perhaps you're going to kill yourself out of grief of the fact that they're not believers. This is what the Prophet's concern was. He almost would kill himself out of grief for the disbelievers. Allah tells him, لَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ. Don't feel depressed. Don't feel sorry for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكَ بَاخِئُ النَّفْسَكَ أَنْ لَا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Perhaps you're going to destroy yourself because they won't be believers. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his major concern, where he put all his effort into, was that the people will obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to His Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, وَلَقَدَ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٌ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. Certainly the prophets before you were rejected. فَصَبَرُوا عَلَى مَا كُذِّبُوا وَأُوذُوا. And they were patient upon that they were rejected and upon the annoyance and the rejection that they found. حَتَّى أَتَاهُمْ نَصْرُنَا. Until our aid and assistance came to them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He keeps His Prophet and makes His Prophet patient. And He commands him to be patient and reminds him that all the prophets that came before him, they were rejected. وَلَقَدَ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٌ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. Certainly, the messengers before you, they were rejected. فَصَبَرُوا. For they were patient. Well, patience is حَبْسُ النَّفْسِ. Patience is to control yourself. It comes from the hadith of Khabbab ibn Arat radiyallahu anhu. Qala shakawna ila rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We went and we complained to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa huwa mutawassidun burtatan, while he was leaning on a burda, a piece of cloth, fi dhill al-Ka'bah, in the shade of the Ka'bah. We went to complain to the Prophet while he was leaning in the shade of the Ka'bah. وَلَقَدْ لَقِينَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ الشِّدَّةِ, and we have met up, or we have received from the disbelievers shiddah. They were punishing the Muslims. فَقُلْنَا, so we said, أَلَا تَسْتَنْصِرُ لَنَا, أَلَا تَدْعُ لَنَا, won't you seek Allah's help for us, won't you call unto Allah for us. I mean, the mushrikeen were torturing them. فَقَالَ, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَدْ كَانَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, afwan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَدْ كَانَ مَنْ قَبْلَكُمْ يُؤْخَذُ الرَّجُلُ فَيُحْفَرُ لَهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Certainly, there was from those who were before you, from Bani Israel. They would take a man and they would dig a hole for him in the land, in the ground. فَيُجْعَلُ فِيهَا, and they would put him in this ground, in this hole. ثُمَّ يُؤْتَى بِالْمِنْشَارِ فَيُوضَعْ عَلَى رَأْسِهِ فَيُجْعَلُ نِصْفَيْنِ. They would take a saw and put the saw on top of his head and cut his head into two halves. وَيُمْشَطُ بِأَمْشَاطِ الْحَدِيدِ مَا دُونَ لَحْمِهِ وَعَظْمِهِ, and they would take combs of steel and put it between his flesh and his bones. Take these combs or these rods or these rakes of steel and run it through their legs between their flesh and their bones. مَا يَسُدُّهُ ذَلِكَ عَنْ دِينِ, none of that would prevent him from being thabit on his deen. None of them would return away from their deen. They would stay thabit on their deen. Wallahi, la yutimmanna Allahu hadha al-amr hatta yasir al-raqib min Sana'a ila Hadramaut. La yakhafu illa Allah wal-dhi'ba ala ghanamih walakinnakum tasta'jilun. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, I swear by Allah, Allah is going to complete this matter. You mean in this deen, Allah is going to complete it. Hatta yasir al-raqib, until a traveler will travel from Sana'a, which is in northern Yemen, ila Hadramaut, that he will travel from Sana'a, which is in northern Yemen, to Hadramaut, which is in southern Yemen. La yakhafu illa Allah. He won't fear anything except Allah. Allah is going to spread this deen. Allah, Prophet says, Allah is, I swear by Allah, that Allah is going to complete this deen and spread this deen. That somebody will travel from Sana'a to Hadramaut, he won't fear anything except Allah. There will be no criminals. There will be no reason for him to fear anything in the land except Allah. Wa dhi'ba ala ghanami, and a wolf or a fox, you know, on his sheep. This is the only thing that he will fear, the fox from his sheep. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ, but you all are hasty. You all are hasty. And hastiness is the opposite of sabrun. Hastiness is the opposite of sabrun. So sometimes, or many times, unfortunately, when somebody wants to establish dawah, their main concern becomes numbers. We have to get the money in. We have to get our numbers up. Okay, what about the obedience to Allah? What about obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And obedience is only going to be established by seeking ilm.
by educating the Muslims, and also by not doing and committing sins, and you know that they're sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ Do you all think that you all will enter Jannah? وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ You think you all will enter Jannah and it won't come to you and you won't be afflicted with the likes of that which people before you were afflicted with? مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالْضَرَّاءُ They were afflicted with بَأْسَاء وَالْضَرَّاءُ They were afflicted with calamities in their bodies and in their wealth, with hardships and fears. وَزُلْزِلُوا And they were shaken and were put in fear. حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ To the point that the Prophet and the believers that were with him, that they said, متى نصر الله When is the help of Allah going to come ألا إن نصر الله قريب Verily the help of Allah is close The help of Allah for your community is close نعم In this ayat Allah tested his prophet and his companions so severely that the prophet himself was saying when is the help of Allah going to come And this is the messenger of Allah If he wanted to, he could help him immediately. But it's very important to be patient. And it's very important that the community be upon obedience. Patient upon obedience. So it's upon us, it's wajib upon all of us to be patient upon obedience to Allah. Whether we have money or we don't have money, and whether we have numbers or we don't have numbers, it has nothing to do with it. The issue is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ وَلَكِنْ you all, rather, you all are hasty. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions. And they were complaining, وَلَقَدْ لَقِينَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ الشِّدَّةِ And we have met from the mushrikeen that they shidda. They were being tortured and they were being punished. And the Prophet said, لَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ Rather, you all are hasty. What would he say about us? We're not being tortured. We have masajid. We have the hijab. Now, we have books. We're able to travel. So what's the call for all this money? What's the call for these numbers? And where's the call for those who are going to be obedient? We are those that are going to enjoy what is right and forbid what is wrong and be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not be concerned that who's with me and who's with that and fulan is with this and we with this sheikh and the sheikh said this and we with that and that. The issue is obedience to Allah. And don't, not that I be misunderstood, it is important that we be together and that we be with the ulama. But we have to be together and we have to be with the ulama upon that which is pleasing to Allah. Let's not forget. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I did not create jinn when man can't accept that they worship me. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُم مِّن رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَن يُطْعِمُونَ I don't want from them their money. وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَن يُطْعِمُونَ I don't want them to feed me. Allah is not in need of us. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ O mankind, أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ You all are the poor and those that are in need of Allah. وَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدِ Allah is the rich, the one not in need of anything. إِنْ يَشَأْ يُذْهِبُكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ If he wanted to, he would get rid of you and come with another group of people. And that is not difficult for Allah whatsoever. Allah will replace us and come with the believers who want to seek his face and please him, no matter what it takes, during hard times, during easy times, during the time where there's poverty, on the time that there's money, in the time when the numbers are small, in the time the numbers are large. We have to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what we wanted to take a look at. Subhanahu wa ta'ala wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Barakallahu feek. Now, we'd just like to announce tomorrow, inshallah, we will have Sheikh Abdul Ghani Al Umari now from Yemen at 2 p.m. live from Damaj. Barakallahu feekum, and I hope everyone benefits from the brother's durus. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The conference organizer has left the conference. The conference is now over. Thank you for using our service. If you have found this service useful, please invite family,